On Monday, we went to the Plankton Food Research Facility. This was one of the stations. These were some of the stations we went to. This one here, images when we were testing how much different types of ground can hold, like rocks and sand and soil. That's the sliding greenhouse, which can move to cover up whatever experiment they're doing. That's one of their containers which they can use to test all about the plant inside it, or grass and like how much water is leaching and that kind of thing. And these are a whole lot of images of like getting the containers, getting these containers and stuff like that. Some questions we had about this were, where is the best soil in New Zealand? Does colour, different coloured potatoes protect them against UV light? Do potatoes grow differently in sand or soil? How much water does soil types of soil hold? How quick is the machine at moving? The glasshouse, I think. How much water is too much water?
At the station of Planted Food Research, we looked at how they brew potatoes. And we had a big talk about them, and quite a few questions, and what the market of today, what, like, potatoes that are good for boiling and mashing, and ones that are good for roasting, and colour, and ones that actually look good. Some of the questions we had about this station was, why do we breed different varieties of potatoes? How does he breed them? Why do the Māori potatoes look like yams? How long have scientists been breeding potatoes in New Zealand? Why improve them, yield slash looks, if we've already got potatoes that we want now?
This was another one of the stations we went to. It was pest control. In this image here, these two images, they have the eggs. The yellow things are the eggs, with the larvae inside. The white things are sewage, and of course that's the bug. That's another bad insect thing. And then this is, it was really cool because we could look through microscopes at all the bugs and eggs and all that. Some questions we had about this were, how do insect pests attack? Why are the smaller pests deadlier? How do psyllids get through biosecurity? When did spuds first arrive? How many psyllids can you find on plant? Why do bacteria kill plants? How many psyllids can a plant tolerate? What type of bacteria does it? What plants do psyllids prefer? And how many insect pests are there?
This was the last station we went to. This is where they test the vitamin C levels. As you can see, we all had to put lab coats on, and it was quite fun. And we got to look at the finished product, which is all this stuff here, which is the tests that they're actually doing right now. And then we got to do some mixing, and how they mix it as they use this tube which they put this chemical in, and they have the test in the bottom, and there's a magnet on the bottom, and there's a magnet inside which spins, and then you can drop this in, and once the liquid inside turns pink, that's how much vitamin C is in here. And we've got a video of it happening here. So that's how they will do it, with the wee magnetic bar inside. And that was all we did at the Plankton Food Research. When we got back, these are the wonderings we came up with for the laboratory. Does the flesh colour have a difference on the vitamin C levels? Black currant versus potatoes. Skin colour.
What is the content of vitamin C in different veggies? How much vitamin C should we have a day? Also, coom reverse potato. What colour is best for us? Should we peel them? Are different coloured spuds better for you? Why measure vitamin C in spuds? And that's it. Thank you for listening.